Hi everyone, welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel if you have been here before. Please hit the subscribe button and subscribe if you haven't yet already. Hit the bell button to get an alert every time I upload something new to the channel, and if you like the video, please hit the like button. It makes me very happy. Today's video is going to be about the Viseart Petite Pro palette. So if you'd like to see how I got this look, please keep watching. Okay, so before I actually start to use the Petite Pro palette, I just wanted to run some comparisons for you between the standard 12 size palette and the smaller Petite Pro. The 12 pan palette is retails for around $80, typically $80 at Sephora and Beautylish. And there are 24 grams, and I'll put this up on the screen too. 24 grams in the palette, so 2 grams for each pan. And the price per pan ends up being $6.67, but you are getting a lot of grams per pan. The Petite Pro is 8 pans. The full gram of the palette is 5.9, so significantly less. Grams per pan is a little bit under 1 gram, so for this one you're getting 2 grams per pan. For this one you're getting a little bit less than one, you're getting 0.7375, so 0.74, and the price per pan here is $3.75, which is, I guess, what you'd expect. It's probably actually equal. You're probably paying the same, close to the same, for the smaller pan. All right, and the packaging for this one, I actually don't remember what the larger pan comes packaged like. I've had this for a while, the larger one. So this comes in this kind of outer envelope, and you open it up and has a little kind of pull ribbon thing, and then it folds down. There's a mirror, small mirror up here, and then these are the 8 pans. Nice mix between mattes and shimmers. And something else, and I haven't really heard anybody else talk about this, but there is a little, I don't know if you can see it, but there is a little kind of lip on each of these, and you can take them out. They're magnetic, so you could put these into a any kind of a palette that you're using, a Z palette or something else. So there's the palette with 1 pan missing. So I'll do some swatches for you, and then I'll come in and do my eyes. I've done everything else on my face except for eyeliner, mascara, and eyeshadow. I have put down a primer, a clear primer. I used my Tarte 360 Creaseless Eye Primer. So it's not going to be giving me any extra like white to make the color pop anymore, but it will keep it on longer. I just always use that. I have plans tonight, so I don't want to have my eyeshadow be wonky, but I expect good things from this. It just is the standard way that I apply eyeshadow. So these are not named, nor are the ones in the larger palettes. So I'm just going to swatch these. So I'll start with the top row. So there's a white, pretty white, kind of a brown, a more kind of red, burgundy, kind of warmer brown, and then kind of like a gray. So these are the 4 colors. And really good pigmentation. And I'll swatch them on my hand. All right, so these are the swatches of the first row. The top is the kind of darker gray, the warmer kind of reddish brown, the other brown, and then you can hardly see this. It's not really white. It's kind of like a very pale kind of beigey color. This is the one on the bottom, and I can see it. I can kind of see it showing up here. It's just very close to my natural skin tone. And then I will swatch the bottom row here. These are really lovely. All right, so here is the bottom row. Ooh, that's lovely. It's kind of like the purple. The one on the edge is kind of a purple, and then more of kind of an orangey kind of copper, more of a gold, and it's more of a champagne. So these are those colors. Really lovely. and I will swatch it. I know that finger swatches are not necessarily the best gauge, but that's what I'm doing right now. All right, so these are the more shimmery shades. This is the champagne one, the gold one, the copper one, and the violet one. So those are all 8 colors. Really nice. I'm gonna wipe the swatches off of my hand and my fingers. I'm gonna dive in. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with this guy. This is the white one. It's not really white, it's more just kind of like a bone or something like that. And I'm gonna pick it up and tap it off. I'm just gonna put this all over my lid just to remove some of the discoloration. That's really smooth. It's another really nice thing about the Petite Pro palette is, I mean, honestly, I go through lipsticks and I go through foundation and I go through concealer and mascara and eyeliner, but it's really rare to go through a powder product. But yeah, I'm never gonna go through it. So the fact that these are smaller is not a problem because I'm just not gonna probably ever go through them unless I love them. They don't sell, I don't know if they sell them in France, but in the US you can't buy the individual pans. So if you're out one, I don't know how you replace one from the others. So I'll actually go in and shade first, and then I'll come in with the shimmer. So I'll go in with, I'll just go from lightest to darkest. So I've already come in with this one. This is the kind of bony pale one. And I'll just move up from lighter to darker. So I'm going in with the next one and going to lay it down. And what I do when I'm going in with a darker color, I do often try to go in with, there's a lot of color here. I needed to tap that off more. It's good that I started with the lightest one because that is, there's a lot of color there. What I do, because I don't want to lay down too much color on one lid, I will put the color down and then I'll put the color on the other lid. I'll just kind of swipe and then go back and forth and blend. But I should have definitely tapped that off more. Wow. So that's good to know. It's highly pigmented. And I am able to move it around. I will actually gonna go in with a little stiffer brush to move it around a little bit more. This was a Sigma E40. And I'm gonna go in with this. This is a Sephora domed crease brush. So I'm just gonna go in and blend this a little bit more. That is pretty. And actually what I'm going to do, because I like to start my, it would be nice if there was a color between this one and this one. I'm not complaining, but it would be nice if there was a color between the two, because I do like to start, I'm just gonna take more of that light color and bring it up on my brow bone a little bit just to kind of remove that stark contrast, just kind of blend it a little bit more. That's something that I do if I have kind of a color that accidentally went a little bit haywire when I was blending back in with the Sephora brush. And sometimes you can't really move the color as much as you want to. And if the color is just gonna stay there, then what I like to do is kind of compensate outside of the guidelines of that area of my eye. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with the darker color. Yikes, that one, just to kind of give it a shot. It's the kind of redder one, a browner redder. This time I'm gonna go in with, this is an Elizabeth Mott blending brush. This came in my March Ipsy bag. All right, and I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna just tap the heck out of this. Wish me luck. Okay. All right. So there's one. Ooh, that's pretty. Okay. Glad that I tapped it off more. I'm actually gonna bring it in even more. I normally don't bring it in on the inner corner of my eye. I normally kind of leave everything out there a little bit less dark, but I'm liking this a lot. Okay. And then finally, I'm gonna go in with this darker color here. And I'm going in with a MAC 217 because I really wanna be able to make this narrow in my crease. There's a lot of color here. A lot of color. So I'm gonna tap, 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 tap. Okay. And I'm going to really shoot for the hollow of my crease. That is nice. Really pretty. Really pretty. But I'm gonna go in with, this is a an e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush, but I just like to go in here afterwards and really just buff this out as much as I can to get it even. Not even, but to get it more buffed, more diffused. Diffuse is the word that I was looking for. Okay. Now I'm ready for some shimmer. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to use all four of these. I'm going to attempt to, but it might be a little bit much. I'm gonna start with the lightest shade, so with this kind of champagne color over here, and I'm going to use a Smith 253 brush, and I'm gonna go in, and I do generally do my eyes first. There is a decent amount of kick up coming here. I'm not sure if you can see that but I'm mesmerized. Wow, that's really pretty. So I am trying to take off as much as I can so I don't have fallout on my face. Wow, that is pretty. Sparkly, tiny, itty bitty hint of glitter. I don't know if you can see that. And the nice thing about this brush is it's, as she drops it. Nice thing about this brush is, and I've seen brushes like this, I think from Sigma or Zoeva, but it's kind of like a teardrop shape with a point on the top. So it's easier to kind of go in with precision and lay down the bulk of the color with the flat of the brush, and then just the, because it narrows at the top. That is really pretty. Okay, so that's the first kind of go that I've done with the shimmer. Now I'll go in with a gold, and I'm gonna use my Vera Mona color switch just to try to keep the color as true as possible. I'll use other brushes for the other colors as I wanna get kind of more precise, but I will use this brush for this next color. So this is gonna be the gold. I'll go in with that gold one right there. And same brush, picking it up, tapping. And this time I'm gonna go on the center of my eye. Wow, that is pretty. So it looks, it's interesting. I'm not sure how it's picking up on camera, but in my mirror, it looks copper. And the next, so this is the one that I'm using. I'm using the gold color. This is the one that looks the most copper in the pan. So I'm curious to see as I move towards the one that's more copper, what that's going to look like. So I'll do the same. I'm not bringing it all the way over. I'm just focusing this on the center of my lid. Okay. That's interesting. It's pretty. I'm not saying that it's not pretty. I'm not saying interesting, bad. I'm saying interesting, wondering if the other one's gonna be oranger. Actually, for this one, I'm going to go in, this is a Real Techniques small detailer brush, and this is clean, so I'm not going to clean it. And I'll go in with this other color, Very Curious. I'm gonna tap it off. And I'll go in, I really wanna see this though. I'm gonna go in on the inner corner. Even though I think it's gonna be darker, I normally wouldn't put something darker on the inner corner, but I do wanna see what this looks like. That is really pretty. It is almost orange. I was describing it as copper. Yeah, the swatches that you do on your hands are, you know, only as good as, the only time that doing a swatch with your fingers, only time that that's a good indication of how the color is going to perform or how the shadow is going to perform is if you would be using it, like if you're using a ColourPop shadow, something that you're going to be applying with your fingers. And also the color on your hand is not necessarily the color on your eyes. So that is interesting. All right, and then finally I'm going to go in and I will again use my color switch with this violet. I'm gonna focus the violet on my outer V. So I'll have used all 8 colors. I'm really liking this. The color payoff is really good. The one thing that I will say is I will, moving forward, be very careful with the mattes to take as much of the product off of the brush as I can before I start blending so I don't put too much pigment on my eyes too soon. So this is the purple. And I'll put this out on my outer V. Ooh. That is pretty. I actually would like to do a look. In fact, maybe I will with this on my full lid. This is a giant explosion of the full palette. I've used all 8, but I will I would like to come in and do something just focusing on the purple. Now I'm gonna go back in with my e.l.f. blush, my e.l.f. One that I used to blur out all of the contour colors, all the matte colors, just to blend this a little bit more. And actually, I'm going to do one last thing. I am going to go back in with the first, this gold color over here, not the one that ended up being more kind of orangey, but with this one. And I'm going to go in again with the Real Techniques brush, just on the tip of the brush. I'm going to put it under my eye. And also just kind of in my tear area. Oh, language. And I am going to, because I'm just a creature of habit and I do feel naked without a cat eye, although this is a lot going on, I am going to apply a cat eye and mascara, and then I'll come right back and give you the final verdict. So this is the final look with eyeliner and mascara and spirit fingers, apparently. I like this a lot. I'm very curious to dig in a little bit more, maybe use that violet color more prominently, mix it up with other palettes. But this is a great palette by itself. It's a great small travel palette. The mirror's not great, it's pretty small, but it's really awesome. So thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you taking time to spend with me with all the different things there are to do in the YouTube universe. Please subscribe if you haven't yet already. Hit the like button if you liked it. It would make me very happy. Hit the bell button to get an alert every time I upload something new to the channel. And I'll see you very soon. Thank you. Bye.